advantage VSAT networks are RBI. RBI has listed out lot of VSAT networks. Advantage, anywhere, anytime banking, EFT transfer, plastic card implementation, inter-branch reconciliation and transfer of DD, MT, etc. Settlement system, emails, circulars, website for employees, customer database, audit and inspection utilization, MIS and risk management, and host of other functions are available in this. Typically, the communication network and EFT systems picturally represented this way, and it has various connections in with different nodes in a mesh type mechanism. There is a central hub which is connected with the internet infinite IP network system. Then there are gateways available for that, and then each bank has connected to gateway and it communicates with through the hub. This is how the picturally this represented SMMS architecture. The PDO and NDS system interfaces, or members are connected to PDO NDS system, and RBI is a member, PDOs are members, and RBI controller, and CCIL is another facility, and DAD department another facility. This picturally this connectivity is represented through this picture. RTGS payments mechanism from bank A to bank B is represented by this way. Bank A connects and there is a payment message sent to the PI system, and then from there it goes to settlement request, and settlement request again, once it is cleared, it goes back to the apex level servers of the RBI, then goes to the bank B and servers of the bank B. And finally, payment is effected. The structured messaging transfer system is called using SWIFT, Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunications, has a limited liability cooperative society established in Belgium, and all major banks of the world are members of it. And the initial objective is to create a central point for passing a secure and standardized messages coming out of banks that mainly interested in payment messages. And there are about 200 different SWIFT messages forms are in existing today. Credit and debit instructions, buy and sell orders, document credits, collection guarantees, etc. So many other formats are there. Nearly 10,300 users are there. Members have number of shares in the capital of the company, which shall be proportionally to the use of the message of the transmissions. And some members are organizations, at least 50% of their directly or indirectly, and 100% directly owned by the members. And there are about 3,342 live members in this, live sub-members. Participants, any organization may be permitted to make use of the specific service of the company as a principal participant and not entitled to share in the capital of the company. These are the few norms of the SWIFT messaging system. And SWIFT messaging system looks like this pictorially. Message layer, and then user application layer, then comes to message layer, then protects against the attacks and other things, and this is a VPN tunnel is given. Automated clearing system is ACS, is more widely popular in the Western countries. CHAPS is originally stood for the Clearinghouse Automated Payment System. However, nowadays this is only referred as acronym CHAPS. And CHIPS is another clearinghouse interbank payment system. The main is the main privately held clearing system. CHIPS forms the primary in US network, largely for large value domestic transactions. And clearinghouse automated transfer system CHATS is another real time gross another RTGS of the system in Hong Kong and other countries. Hong Kong dollar, Hong Kong and other countries, it's used as since 2005. Fedwire is another way of electronic funds transfer system, two-level funds transfer system. It is real-time gross settlement in the Federal Reserve of US, used by any institution that has account with the Federal Reserve. Almost offline connection and online connections available. And Bankwire is another way of transmitting the EFT systems. Bankwire is the pioneer in the private sector electronic communications, and for banks in USA, used to transfer messages between the subscribing banks. It was originally conceived and for reducing the cost of transmitting the messages between the participating banks, and the transmission pertains to both funds transfer as well as the administrative messages also. Point of sales, POS. POS is a point of sale, the physical location at which goods are sold to customers. And the point of sale is the typical location of the transaction, but usually refers to any device or system used to record the transaction for the retailer. CPOS is a computer-based POS terminal which employs software to implement POS functionality. Point of sale is, or POS, it is more commonly abbreviated, refers to the capturing of data of the customer payment, informing the information at the physical location when goods are sold to him. The POS transactions are captured using a variety of devices, which include the computers, cash registers, optical and bar scanners. RTGS is real-time gross settlement, which is a acronym for RTGS is real-time gross settlements, in which funds are transferred from one branch to one bank, one branch of the bank to other branch of the bank across India. And these are gross settlements made on the spot. Once it is settled, it's irrevocable. This is a fastest possible money transfer system through the banking channel. Settlement in real time means payment in transactions are not subjected to any waiting period. The transactions are settled as soon as they are processed. Gross settlement means that the transaction is settled on the one-to-one basis without bunching them or waiting for a batch process. NEFT is a national electronic payment system, funds transfer. NEFT stands for National Electronic Funds Transfer. Funds are transferred to the credit of other participating bank's customer's account through RBI's NEFT service. RBI acts as the service provider to transfer the credits from one bank to other bank. NEFT operates on deferred settlements, DNS, which means all the funds collected in a batch mode and processed finally arrived at a netting position and then settled with the respective banks. Why RTGS and NEFT is required now? It is a need of the hour, and also the customer demanding requirements like faster settlement of funds, faster movement of cash at their disposal. All these requirements, customer demanding requirements, are the reasons, and also advancements in technology, telecommunications and computer technology enable this. And also the legality to the transactions, Payment Settlement Act is one of the acts enable the transaction to be legalized, and banks are obliged to abide by these acts regulations. Lower cost of transactions, RTGS and NEFT, as compared to the cost of transactions of remitting through draft, etc. Customer benefit, immediate credit is available, fastest way of credit to them. Lower transaction time, no printing, shorten the queues. Drafts will be phased out in the coming years. For a funds transfer to go through RTGS and NEFT, both sending bank and receiving bank should have the RTGS and NEFT enabled services protocol with them. The rare cases, the system failure, RBI banks, respective software, etc., or manual interventions are required to the funds process system. However, it is a very rare occasion, and errors are minimized. Currently, CNEFT is the transactions are settled in batches based on the following times: 11 settlements on weekdays, and 5 settlements on Saturdays. This is the current schedule available with the NEFT settlements. The current RTS and NEFT limits are 2 lakhs and maximum is no limit. And for NEFT, no limit for minimum and maximum also no limit. After understanding these requirements of data communications and various methods of network communications and the methods of transmitting the data from one end to other end or funds transfer or messaging from one end to other, it all requires a secure environment. Secure environment can be provided in the data communications through secure FTPs, file transfer protocols, or HTTPs, hypertext protocols, transfer protocols, etc. And VPN is another one, virtual private network is another one. However, the signal message that has been generated from one end to other end to ensure that it is not tampered, it is not pilfered in the process of transmission, the mechanism that is used is digital signature. Digital signature is nothing, is not like a physical signature which you sign on a paper and then scan it or attach it. It's not like that. It's a bitstream mechanism, and the signature is through algorithm, and the person who applies the signature, this signature, has to apply for 2 keys, which is called private key and public key. The private key is solely owned by him and has to be kept in personal custody in a secret manner, confidential manner, and public key is available for anybody who wants to verify his signature, whether it's been generated by the person holding the private key. In other words, the verification key is called public key, and the person who actually wants to verify can verify the authenticity of the person who generated that message. Why this signature is required? To provide authenticity, to high integrity and non-repudiation. What is non-repudiation? Non-repudiation is supposing a person, suppose I send a message and later on if I say I have not sent the message, that is called repudiation. And to prevent repudiation from of the message being sent by one person, the digital key, digital signature is used. Digital signature is one way helps us under non-repudiation. That means a person cannot challenge of not sending the message. The use of internet as a safe and secure medium for e-governance, etc., the digital signatures are used. Digital signatures employ asymmetric cryptography, and the scheme typically consists of 3 algorithms, and the hash value of the message when encrypted with the private key of the person becomes a document. The private key is used for making the digital signature. Public key is used to verify the signature of the person. Let us sum up. After understanding the, after going through the 31 module, let us sum up. The highlights of the data communication requirement was highlighted, and need was examined by the committees, different various committees deployed during the period. And then each committee has recommended certain of technologies, networking of the banks, bank and financial institutions, understand the various networks in financial sector, understand the various modes of data communication like data media, data processes, data equipments, etc. The various types of transmitting the data transfers like chips, chaps, charts across the world, and also within specific reference to India, NEFT, RTS, etc. This brings us to the conclusion of unit number 31, and thank you very much.